So this is a three sheet that was discovered under the floorboards of a home in Whitby, Ontario. The three sheet was essentially used as a cost-effective underpadding or insulation. It's called the Prince Chap. It has nail holes in it, and it has these cross lines, missing paper, and so on. And it had a brown craft paper was glued to the back of it. And that's what we're doing now. We're peeling away the brown craft paper. This poster has been soaking in water for the last 12 to 18 hours. So now we're preparing the board for the canvas to linen back the poster. So we'll put the canvas on the board. We use a wheat starch adhesive. Since the canvas has been glued, now we're laying the acid-free Japanese masa paper that has also been glued, and then we'll be rolling it and putting the poster on top of this. We're gingerly gluing the back of the poster, and we're about to lay it down onto the acid-free Japanese masa paper. Good?
Yeah.
Okay. When we lift the plastic, the last thing you want is for the poster to lift off with the plastic. So you want to preserve as much of the original poster paper as possible. So as we were removing the brown craft paper off the back of this poster, little pieces of the original poster were breaking off. This blue piece right here fits right here. You want to replace as many of these original pieces as possible. So now we're dealing with a very large puzzle because there's all sorts of different pieces that we have to try and fit back together. There had to be at least 100 little pieces. It took us hours to replace the paper. And a big part of that was trying to figure out where all the pieces went.
The next step is to airbrush out any large flat areas that are damaged. And this will help conceal any of that replaced paper. Now the background is all covered. I need to wipe off the paint and then the credits will be revealed. Now filling in every little hole here, there must be hundreds of nail holes now. I'm just going to use the pencil crayons to fill those in, and it gets the same texture as the printing inks had back in the day. And I'm going to use the pencil crayons to recreate that color in this section of the image exactly, so you won't notice that at all. And I want it to look as close as to the original printed artwork as possible.
What a day, see those skies, just as blue as my baby's eyes. What a day for somebody and me. What a day, hold that rice, come on Parson and kiss her twice. What a day for somebody and me.